kids these days. Computers, internet, mobile phone.
What up, Eric?
Thanks! Here's your deck back. You psyched to see Muska's demo? JT.
Restarting in case it takes a second for us to be heard. I feel like we lost our momentum. There we go, let's go.
Oh, cool. Alright, so we got a little Need for Speed Underground action.
Yeah.
No.
This game has a lot of driving segments, each level, for a skating game.
There's at least one vehicle mission in every level. We don't do them all, in any percent. We're not doing blimp.
Well, maybe you're not doing blimp.
Oh, you're doing blimp? Okay.
No,
all right,
no,
cool.
No, no.
Alright.
The driving physics are so goofy, I'm a big fan.
They're a little weird.
So there's gonna be some strats at Doctos that Gib won't be doing.
That's right.
You're Joey, right?
Doc is a gamer. Both are gamers.
About 3 minutes.
There we go.
We're Tony in.
So you notice, I do a lot of. You're gonna see boneless 180 judo a lot. That's like a really quick combo to get a ton of points in the game. It's probably the most efficient way to get points in the game.
Well, get your special bar.
So you'll see, it's gonna get special bar up and also points. So anytime you see points, there's probably gonna be a bonus 182 involved somewhere.
Yeah. You may have noticed on my stream, during the call out the trick skull, I had actual tricks and he just had to do one trick. You want to explain what that is, Doc?
Yeah, I'll explain that. So, there's a trick in this game, which is referred to as Cat Bag, which is an abbreviation for Create a Trick, Broken Ass Game. So, what it is there's a feature of this game called Create a Trick, where you can make a trick that like looks cool or anything like that. It's meant to be for like stylish reasons. However, if you make a trick and then name it another trick and then bind it to every single like directional flip or grab. Sorry, I just had to hit that real quick. That's a trick called Bridge Skip. It skips the driving sequence that Gib is doing. Anyways.
That's another thing that I don't do compared to him.
Yeah. There's a lot of stuff within the first couple minutes, but I'll try to explain it. But back to Create a Trick, you basically bind every single directional flip and grab to the same trick, and it allows you to, when you have the RNG sections that run, I only have to do one trick. They're not very useful for points, but... I didn't hit.
Did you miss Eric's skiff as well?
I did. Oh, you missed it as well? Okay.
Yeah.
Alright. So there's a trick there. Oh, go ahead.
There's a one, or I believe it's a one-frame trick, if not a couple frames, where if you jump Ollie at the very end of that as you're sketching the car, which you're not supposed to be able to do, but you can get ahead of it with a little out of bounds. If you jump at the very end at the right frame, you can skip that last driving section that we both just did. It's pretty hard to pull off under pressure.
Saves about 20, 30 seconds.
Yeah, it saves quite a bit of time. Oh, alright. I just bailed.
It's probably the single biggest, like, actual skip that there is in the game. There's not a lot that you can concretely skip, just a lot of very fast movement and comboing.
Yep. Alright, my controller just, like, stopped wanting to get off my board. Alright, come on. Okay. Alright, what? Okay. So getting on and off your board is actually, like, pretty crucial here, because you can kind of change, like, your direction mid-air.
Getting off your board in general is a super powerful tool that makes me love this game in particular for the Tony Hawk games.
Yeah, he's going to avoid bailing. It's very, very...
Avoid bailing and also just air control is insane.
Yeah,
and you can hit an Indy 900 to get off of your board and it'll still count as long as you don't bail. Check out my buddy's
sick line. Yep. I'm playing Thug 2 like right after this, and you'll notice that they nerfed a good majority. I just failed that. Okay. you'll notice that I smacked him. You'll notice that they nerfed the mobility that you have in the air in all the games after this.
But you get hot rod.
You do, but we'll get to that when we get to Thug 2.
Yep. Do we want to go ahead and explain butt slaps?
Yeah. All right. So there's another trick which really like is super important in New Jersey. It's important like elsewhere in the run as well, but New Jersey's like the biggest use of it. So when I did the bridge skip there, which skips like the sketching all the way around, there's a trick called butt slapping, which I was told that it's called that because you're slapping the buttons, but that may be a myth. However, basically what happens is you roll off a ledge, you do a trick, and then you spam Ollie. And if you spam Ollie in the little short time frame that you have, you can get extra Ollies in, basically. And you can get, like, insane air from it.
Oh. I think I just did a dialogue.
Most people can get doubles and triples decently consistently. There's only a couple people who can get quads consistently.
Yeah, it's every time, like, after two, it gets increasingly harder.
There's a very minor trick on this boneless skull where you can, instead of jumping over this rail it asks you to, you can just grind on it, which saves a couple seconds. I really like that.
It's a good one.
You can also just boneless into this ramp, and it counts instead of getting huge air off it.
Yeah, so any sort of like ramp to where it says, hey, do a trick on here, if you just hit a trick on it and don't bail, it'll count.
Yeah.
Assuming there's some downtime, I'd like to acknowledge that Kane California has donated in total 200 bits. Unfortunately,
let's go.
Unfortunately, Kane is not able to donate through the Twitch way, but any donations, any subs, no matter what, will still go to the designated charities that we support.
Absolutely.
For this, of course, we're mainly focusing on the Trevor Project, but of course, we're also supporting 350.org and Save the Children. All three, including the Trevor Project, really great causes. I'll just leave it to you.
Cool. This is Tampa. Tampa's kind of infamous, in the Tony speedrunning community. There's a total of 3 minutes of auto scrollers in here. Sorry, 4 minutes technically if you include Tony. 3 minutes of it's just back to back, so we're gonna have a lot of downtime coming up here. So I'll probably try to like showcase some like Easter eggs and stuff because there's literally nothing else to do.
Yeah, and you'll probably just show up with buttons up as well.
Yeah. You'll notice that me and Gib like both try to like grind a lot. Grinding is like slightly faster than just like riding around on your board.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, do you wanna explain super sketching as well?
Yeah, I did it like a little bit in Manhattan. I didn't get a good one, but if you sketch a car vehicle, and then you stop sketching, and then you grind a whole bunch, you get an insane amount of speed, because sketching kind of unlocks your speed cap, and then you get like an insane amount of speed by just keeping grinding and shuffling. I hit the tree.
Unfortunate.
That's all right.
Bad RNG.
All right, what fever party? So this is another like RNG section. So all I have to do is just hit these three. I just do three tricks. This is another kind of fun one. You're supposed to like wall plant that, but you can just wall push and it'll give the gap that the game's looking for. This one's pretty self-explanatory.
So there is the lore to the story, but it's not as prevalent as honestly Thug 2, in my opinion.
The story is pretty prevalent here if we do not skip all the cutscenes.
Yeah. There's a lot of lore that we don't get to see between the skaters.
Yeah. Like Eric Sparrow.
The journey from New Jersey rookie to pro skater.
Yeah. So I'm gonna take some time here while we're in the auto scroller to like get a few stats up. So I'm just gonna grind here, get some stats.
I'm gonna throw off one of my favorite bails that you can do in this game. Oh. I might miss it. No. Oh well. I'll get to see it in a minute.
I think I'm gonna disrespect Tony real quick. I'm just gonna hit some Indy 900s right in front of him.
I just got Afro Gym, which is not something worth explaining in a marathon, but any veterans will find it interesting.
Okay, so for the competitions, what you can do is you can start a combo and then hit end run while you're still in the middle of the combo, and the game will count it. So I just get all these points and then hit end current run and it'll still count it. And that skips quite a lot. Okay, so we're into the big auto scroller section now.
Yep. Afro gym thing I mentioned, you might notice these doors just glitching in and out. It's like a cutscene skip thing. And I also can't get back into the competition now. It's like a weird one frame cutscene skip thing. It doesn't really do anything useful, but it's funny.
So 120,000 is probably enough. So I'm just gonna go mess around for a couple of minutes. There's this car that people are doing things in. This is where Mayor Jed Security just kind of likes to chill out, you know? I guess I'll go over here to show. This is what we were talking about with super sketching. So if I...
It's one of my favorite like bails in the game right here.
Oh, in there.
Okay. Let's go super sketching together.
This is... So you notice I'm kind of like flying in the air because, and you can kind of hear the skater. I don't know if how prevalent the audio is, but you can hear the skater doing extra ollies.
Yeah, every single ollie is a butt slap itself. And so after four and more, it's a lot harder to count because it all gets muddled together.
That was
Really, like, there's no place in the run where we do any more than like three, even for advanced strats. Four makes certain things easier, but really there's like not a ton of places where it's prevalent. New Jersey's is honestly like the biggest place that you're gonna see butt slaps. There'll be like a few other points here, but just land like a million point combo there, and then we're going on to the next round of
optimally to get over the bridge without getting a skitch at all. You just hit seven or eight butt slaps,
which is it's a task strat.
It's
a task strat.
And I do a cheeky little out of bounds right here. It's a neat little thing.
Oh, okay, I know where you're going. Yeah, that was kind of funny. I'm gonna go see the goat.
I'm gonna see the crocodile. The alligator. I know my animals.
Here's the goat. So, like we said, this is an auto-scroller, so I'm just gonna sit here and chill for the next 30 seconds. And then we're gonna go into San Diego.
So, if they have any sort of downtime, they would have their stats already boosted. Well, they already have them right now boosted, but what they would do is they hold grinds, lip tricks, manuals, let's see what else, grab tricks. Yo, let's get some photos for your first
flip tricks if you want to do flips, but I don't have any flips for me, so.
All right, let's... I think after the first three caveman combo, you don't do it anymore. That's like all you need to do, so. Man, you just do that in New York.
Oh, so here's another interesting thing with San Diego, because I'm doing this trick called Cat Bag. The game gets confused because it's trying to do a double directional, but I don't have double directionals because it's a created trick. So it just says temp.
So and also get off your board during those at the end, and you do a little levitate, and it saves a little bit of time as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, because normally it would just stop you in your board. It'd take probably like half a second to a second long. Somewhere around there.
Hey, you. This goal will be a good visual example of Cat Bag, where we have to do all these tricks over the thing. He just has to do one trick.
Yep.
I have to do several. Which doesn't actually lose any time to do them. Just a little more thing you have to do to make sure I don't mess anything up and actually get them done.
Yep, so now I'm just going to hold this combo, because as long as you have the gap in your trick string, and you have one of the tricks it's looking for there, the game's going to just say, okay, I almost quit the game, but I don't want to do that. Oh, I didn't hit the butt slap. Oh, shit.
With this goal where you have to do wall plants on these walls to place some stickers, if you have it's kind of like the gap thing. If you just have the wall plant in your combo, you can just ride your board into them and they count. Which is pretty neat.
It's going to be a lot of getting gaps in your combo, so.
You want to talk about the wall plant restart, by the way?
Oh yeah, I totally overlooked that too.
This is also used in Hawaii.
Oh, I missed that one. Oh, come on, bud. Oh, come on. Oh, okay.
Nah, not today.
This one's kind of annoying, so that's why that trick is used. I can't do this. So like I said before, getting special before like a lot of these like longer goals just like allows you to go a little bit faster.
Yeah, having that special meter full makes you just physically move a little bit faster for everything.
Yeah. Oh, thanks, truck. Alright.
We love driving the security cart. It does not have totally insane physics whenever you try to go left and right on a slope.
Absolutely not. It's the best car in the game by far, of course.
No, that's the blimp.
Oh yeah, of course. Sorry, best car with wheels in the game.
Okay.
To be more specific.
The blimp is kind of a the bloat cart kinda phases it out a little bit, you know. Bloat cart.
Normally with sketching the security cart for 30 seconds you have to ride it out, but you can just kinda ollie in place and do it that way and it's a little faster once again.
Yeah, I believe it takes like 1 second every time you leap off, and if you spin, the cart will slow down, so it's a little faster.
There's so many neat little tricks in this game that have, like, you play this game casually as a kid, as a, Doc, did you play this game as a kid?
I did not, actually.
Okay. I know a couple other people that, like, we've been running with have played it as a kid, and they, it's nice finding things, or learning things that are just little glitches that make the game faster.
Yeah, it's very cool.
Or are neat.
Yeah.
I wanted to...
Oh, good.
I was just going to ask, are both of you doing the same route just with different strats attempted?
Yeah,
pretty much.
The game, for the most part, like, only has one, like... route. There's some different goals you can do, but it's pretty obvious which ones are faster and which ones aren't. But there are very, like, little niche strats in every goal that we might be doing differently.
Makes sense, yeah.
So, Gib is done with demo time. Unfortunately, this is not Pro Skater 3 to where it could be TV time. But, it's grabbing the letters, going to be, let's see here, this one is getting laid. And then afterwards, it is smashing the pineapple stands.
Oh no, shoot.
So, there is a grind to where you hit in Hawaii, to where you grind from the balcony over here, and you grind upwards, grab the secret tape, even though you don't need it, to the hotel roof, then that unlocks hotel roof early. To where there's an elevator to where you can take, and you need to get up to the hotel roof later on where you can just go through the elevator quickly.
Yeah. Just reaching the roof, like, unlocks this elevator that we'll see in probably 20 seconds from now.
Other than that, Hawaii probably has one of the hardest goals of the game, to be honest. I know you've said it is the hardest, Doc.
Yeah, it's a hard goal. Hold on, I'm having a scumble. There we go. Yeah, Wallows is like, whoops, notoriously like kind of difficult.
Forgot what I was doing. No.
All right.
Messed up a little bit there, but
so yeah, really you don't... just use the hotel roof early to get down to the ledge where he has to drop into the pool.
Once again, Tony Hawk doesn't know how to count, so if we restart and then do this, that's somehow three, even though there was definitely just two.
Instead of having to climb the hotel back in that goal, you can just hop in the elevator and get up to the top, and then jump down.
Right. There we go. That's good. We're just impressing the girls, but I can just kind of do these combos near them and then land it. And they're impressed.
Who wouldn't be? 5,000 point combo, that's kind of insane.
Your combo is so big.
I'm gonna redo this.
And then Doc is on, onto what I would consider the hardest goal of the game.
Yeah, the hardest singular goal.
The second place where you can skip the hotel climb, that just ends right there.
I should mention that there's other things with Catbag that you do, like, because of the way it works, you can name, like, a bunch of tricks, so I have a bunch of tricks bound that are, like, different, like, double directional tricks, and I can use those, like, at any point to skip, like, certain things, like, Gib is gonna do an actual McTwist up on this roof. Spoiler alert, if you haven't seen it.
Yeah.
There it is. I'm gonna do a fake McTwist.
But you gotta get it first time.
I don't, because I have one bound.
Oh, okay.
I have one bound. I just don't use it. I just have it bound.
Normally when you jump over that helicopter, there's a nice slow-mo bit for the cinematic enjoyment. Whoops.
Yeah,
but if you go to the right of it, right. You can just... Yeah.
There's my fake McTwist. My character just kind of... I could do my boneless judo. Alright, thank you. Whatever.
I don't think I remember all
some of these are a little tighter, but...
I remember all the double directional cat bags off the head, off of my head, but I know handstand.
Ah, there's a lot.
McTwist. So I mean, it's basically to make goals go a lot quicker.
Oh, please.
There we go. There's a whole lot, like you can cat bag like every single like trick, but you only have like so many trick slots, and like also I'm not that good at certain directions for double directional. Like I'm really not that good at up, so I don't have anything bound to my up.
For the record, I just messed up and had to redo this goal.
Do you want to talk about manuals and how you can go up or down depending on the trick and still land it?
Oh yeah, okay, that's fine. For pretty much like most of the common ones, besides two rail, you push it, your meter up, and it'll end the manual. It's a little bit faster than just ollieing. Again, just kind of making use of the rails to grind wherever possible. And we're going to be taking the limo in a second here.
So yeah, Vancouver, very short level, very fun level, to be honest.
Yeah, this is a good level.
It's a nice level.
Go into what I call Slim Jim City.
Slam Jam City.
Thank you.
Yeah. I don't know. I've referred to it as Slim Jam City so much, right? I don't remember the actual
name. The official name is the Slam City Jam, for the record. Felt like that needed to be clarified after
yes,
that one.
Yes.
Cacophony of names.
Pretty much all it is just like a pro like arena in Vancouver.
Yeah, there's a bunch of competitions.
Yeah. In Tampa, we became like amateurs.
Yeah, it's amateurs.
Yeah, pro-am.
And then now we're gonna be pros.
Yep.
Assuming
so
we
after...
beat the contest, of course.
Oh well, yeah, of course. I mean, we're gonna beat the contest.
Well, I have faith in.
This is another thing. I'm just gonna do an Indy 900, and then the judges are gonna be. All right, never mind.
Oh no!
Let's try that again. So I just do the Indy 900 and then stop, and judges are like, whoa, and then they just give me 90 points.
Indy 900. Me, I'm going to do some flatland tricks to get my points up.
Oh, I'm with that guy.
For these competitions, you just have to get in third place or higher to be become a pro.
Yeah. That's how it is with any of the competitions. So just like back in Tampa, along with here, and this is the last one, isn't it? Or is there one more?
Yes, this is the last one.
This one is a mini auto scroller. You don't have to beat this
refreshing.
In a fast time. Now we're back in Vancouver.
Yeah.
I think we're pretty close, if I had to guess.
I just got to Vancouver too, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you both are decently still close.
So now that
you go.
Now that we're pros, I'm gonna try to get my stats up. So we're gonna be at max stats for the rest of the game now, pretty much. Just kinda rolling around.
I may or may not have messed up the manual's goal earlier and had to redo it.
Oh, I just, alright, I was trying to do a strat where you get whacked by the bus, but I bailed on top of the bus, so I can't do that.
That's funny.
Now you're in a little bit of a time crunch.
That's alright.
Hey, American.
So yeah, right, normally we're in Moscow. Normally if you get smacked by the bus, you'll respawn to where you can just do a wall ride into a grind and be up by that little trophy that you get.
Yep.
I think it's like
not server people. Caveman didn't count? There we go.
Operation D's what?
The original.
Ah. Oh no. Not Operation D's.
Alright, there it is.
Operation D's what?
D's nuts.
It's a little. Everybody's watching. Okay. Just got D's nuts from 2003. Thank you.
Oh, okay. That's right. Okay.
Thank you for coming out.
Speed Simpson is family friendly. We will not tolerate. No.
No! Uh oh. That's something I've never
done. I'm trying to do this.
Oh, no.
I'm trying to do this cool strat. I kind of want to show this off.
Oh, at least you were able to recover.
That was fast.
There we go.
Alright.
Oh, you're trying to do your wallet? Very nice.
Now we're just gonna impress the Russians, I guess? I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know what
this
part of the story is.
At Rodney Musk in with some Flatland, and then,
Rodney Musk?
Musket.
Sure.
Alright, I don't know why my controller decided to do a Indy 900, but it did. That's alright. So you're supposed to do the combo there, like in front of the statue, but if you just do it all in a combo, it's like, okay, and then it just allows you to.
So yeah, there's a couple instances where you do that. You do that in New Jersey for Chad Muska. There's, what, like maybe like one or two other times that you do it, a couple other times, right?
Yeah, don't know
you might notice a bit of a time difference between me and Doc for this next section, in terms of the daylight.
Somebody remind me, I swore.
Wait, daytime Moscow, let's go.
Ain't no way.
Alright, this goal hates me today, apparently.
Do you want to explain the 720 spins? Or the,
yeah.
The butt slap spins?
I'll explain it in a second, yeah. So there's a trick, it's known as like stupid spines or sub spines. It was found by somebody called some Sub-Zero, so that's why it's called sub spines or stupid spines. But Gib is doing 5720s, which is, you know, what you kind of are supposed to do. However, I'm going to do a 720, 540, if I can get back over, that'd be cool, a 360. And a 360, and I have 13, because that's how math works. So it's a weird glitch where if you butt slap and then you keep it all in a combo, it does some kind of very weird math. There's a faster way to do it. Yeah, there's a faster way to do it, but I don't regularly hit the 900. It requires a triple, and I'm not that good at mashing, so.
I had another cutscene skip thing, so I'm playing in the daytime, and Doc is playing in the nighttime.
Yeah. It is supposed to be nighttime, however, Gib is really good at mashing through cutscenes.
My one skill.
Everybody gets one skill.
Everybody gets one.
Yeah, they're both picking up Russian women at the moment. And then they will be going to go get a hangover cure and then escaping Moscow.
Yep. Moscow is a pretty fun level.
I agree.
That's like cool little things that you do.
There'll be a nice little bailout here that saves a couple seconds. You warp to the next object, essentially.
So, do you do that trick as well when you escape Moscow, or no?
No.
Okay.
Get up there.
You can hit a triple and get out of Moscow a different way, but I'm not good at hitting triples, so I just ignore it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a very difficult trick to do.
So if you hit a triple, get out of Moscow, you can go out of bounds, and it'll respawn you by the place where you need to escape Moscow.
Okay. There we go. I can, however, but slap up and get up that ladder, though, without having to use the ladder, which is kind of nice. But this has been a kind of trashy Moscow, but it's not. Alright, so this is another thing with Catbag. So Gib has to do, like, get special. I just do one trick.
Alright, let's go soul skating.
Yep. My soul skating is a dude eating pizza and doing a backflip, so... thought that's kind of cool.
Come with the city, do all the tricks. So,
with this is another dot, one. Ellipse.
Got pretty decent RNG with only 3 glib tricks.
Yeah, sometimes you can get like a lot. Glib tricks.
I got like 5, I think, which is not the best, but it's all good.
Yeah.
And then finally, you need 50k points, unlock pro team, and then you roll with the pros.
Yeah, so each of these have like their own challenge that you're going to do with the pros. Bob's challenge is just kind of sitting here. Oh, I lost that apparently. Okay, I got a cool concept for. It's all right. All right. Next up's the Florida challenge.
So the Florida one is actually pretty cool.
It's kind of restricting your movement to previous THPS games, so like,
oh yeah,
at first it's like no walking, then it's like no revert or something like that, and then it's like no manuals, and then like no, it progressively gets like harder, like just basically going back all the way to THPS 1, like the moveset that you had.
Yeah, it goes 4-3-2-1. You do have to get less points, thankfully, on each one. So you start off with 10,000, 8,000, 5,000, 3,000, I believe. Something like that.
Yeah, that sounds right. Or 2,000.
That was the last one.
Also, probably my least favorite goal, because if you mess any of it up, you have to start from the first combo, and it's like one of the only goals that punishes you that hard.
Yeah, I would agree with that, too.
It's a very big run killer for some.
So we're coming up on a skip.
Me, really.
Oh. Gib got vid skip.
I also got vid skip.
Very nice. That's a run.
So
this is going to be tight.
It's a frame perfect hitting A and hitting pause at the same time. To where instead of watching a 15-second video, to where you just go to the menu and you go to New Jersey once again. And we are the happiest people in New Jersey once again.
No! Oh gosh.
Oh no. Oh. He got it.
That was insane. Oh gosh. Must have changed my stance because I'm feeling the pressure right now.
Nice joke, kid. Thank you.
Kind of a little comedy.
Oh yeah. Tango. Can't go anywhere with you.
This last goal is a nice leisurely stroll through the streets of New Jersey.
Yeah, we're just basically trying to... The story is that Eric said he's going to give you back your tape if you beat him at his own line.
Yeah, that Hawaiian tape.
Shredding his line.
On the helicopter gap that we did. When I jumped over to the side of the helicopter and it looked awesome.
Time. Oh, wow. We were like 5 seconds apart or something.
Yeah, that's...
All right, that's really good.
That's a good race.
Very good.
Did you have your live split up?
Yeah.
Just curious. What did you get?
I got 39.04 in game
39.15.
That's a good race right there.
Yeah, that's a good race. Well,
Doc, it looks like you're playing Char.
Oh, shoot. I did say I was going to play Char tomorrow if I lost. All right.
Love to see it. Speed Simpsons, you know. We'd love to see it.
All right.
All right.
So...
And that is Tony Hawk's Underground.
Yeah. So GG's to both of the runners on their very close race. We will be right back, I guess, with Doc doing a solo run of
it will be me.
Run the sequel of this game.
Yeah. Much shorter.
It's gonna be a lot faster.
A lot faster.
There's going to be a lot going on, so I'm going to try to explain it all.
But instead of one goal at a time, you're doing like 10 goals at a time. It's my understanding.
Yeah, it's pretty much if they took this game and they just did cocaine. That's just pretty much what the game is. So,
Yeah, there's not really much more to explain from Thug 1 to Thug 2, thankfully. So, all you have to just deal with it is just... High paced.
Yeah, I'll show it all off in a second here. But
thanks everyone for watching, and thanks for posting and commentating.
No problem.
Respective
Thank
individuals.
Yeah. See you.
That was a fun race.
It was really good.
GG's.
GG's, Doc, as well. GG's.